Hi, Microbe Hunter here, and today no microbe hunting but rather insect hunting, and I'm gonna show you now 5 tips on how you can better observe insects under the stereo microscope. And I hope that this way I'm also gonna get you interested in stereo microscopy, because most of my videos that I've made up to this point were about using compound microscopes. Now, insects can be a little bit difficult to observe under the stereo microscope because insects are pretty restless. Many of them move around, crawl around, some of them fly away, of course, and it's difficult to chase them under the microscope. At the same time, you have to operate the focusing knob and so on. So it's a little bit difficult sometimes, but there are a couple of tricks and tips that I'm gonna share with you today that can make life a little bit easier, because one of the things that you don't want is you do not wanna miss out on those very rare and interesting little occasions. For example, when an insect poops right in front of you and then you don't have it in focus, like for example, in this case. So I'm going to start off right away, and the first and most easiest way to observe insects is that you simply try to find dead insects somewhere in your house or in your apartment. Sometimes it's good not to be too clean, because then you find maybe some of these dead insects lying around somewhere, and of course they can be easily observed under the stereo microscope. Unfortunately, some of them have accumulated some dust a little bit, and this of course does not make the insect appear quite as nice. But I would say that is the first thing that you might want to try out, and in many cases the results are quite acceptable. Of course, you do not want to look at insects that are decaying or decomposing. It's also a health issue, of course, and so you don't want to touch it. If this kind of is not something for you, you can of course also buy prepared insects which are cast in plastic, and they can also be observed under the stereo microscope, and of course they can also produce very nice and colorful and beautiful results, like for example, like here. Those two beetles also are quite nice. And of course, check your lamps. Lamps, of course, they attract insects, and sometimes they are accumulating there as well. And very often they're quite bright and white because the intense light bleached them out, and therefore they look much brighter than they actually do. And they're pretty fragile as well, and they tend to fall apart. Second suggestion, no dead insect, well, then you have to unfortunately kill them. You have to go out and catch the insects like I have done, and then you use a substance called ethyl acetate, and you basically put some of this ethyl acetate on tissue paper together with the insect. The insect inhales it, that's the substance here, and after a few minutes it dies. Of course, this is ethically an issue, and of course you're not allowed to kill of course protected insects this way. So this is why when we did this project, we hired an entomologist, an insect specialist, who was sorting out the insects before we actually killed them to do our insect investigation and insect determination. But that's simply the way it is. You have to kill the insects because some of the structures you can only see if you separate the wings and if you turn the insect around, and you cannot simply do that with live insects. And often it's necessary to kill the insects to do a biodiversity study, also because of our environmental protection example, when climate change also can change the insect population. And in order to do that, you have to catch insects and you have to document them properly, and using that is only possible when you actually also unfortunately kill them, and then you can also put them into a collection box. So you don't want to kill insects, so I suggest you can do the following. Put the insects into a plastic container and put some clear foil over it, like I've done here. In this case, insects cannot fly away, and you can observe them directly through the clear foil. Still causes the insect to move around, but it does limit their movement a little bit, so at least if it moves away, then at least it doesn't run off your microscope somewhere, or does not fly away, but you can simply recenter the whole dish. And then it is possible to also take pictures, and the nice thing here is of course here the insects are moving, and this ladybug for example is now cleaning its legs a little bit. Now, a second thing is if you do not want to observe moving insects, but if you want that they're really resting very quietly, but at the same time you don't want to kill them, then put the insect into the refrigerator. This will cool them down so much, and when they're cold enough, then this also will limit their movement. And this is actually also a way how you can also take pictures of bees and wasps. And the last, my favorite method is you have to make sure that the insect feeds on something, because when it's feeding, it's also not running away as quickly. So I have collected some stinging nettle, and on the stinging nettle there was this little beetle, this trunked with a little trunk, and this is the snout beetles, they're actually called, and they're having this long nose, this long snout, as for sucking the sap of the plant. And this is how I was able to make these videos here. It was not running around anymore, it was simply concentrating on feeding off the sap, and this also made it much easier for me to get a very nice video. And also very fascinating is to still be able to see how they're moving, but because they're not moving as much around, it's much easier to video and to film the actual life of the insect. Now, if I was able to create a little bit of interest in stereo microscopy, I do have a few other videos about this topic as well. For example, you might want to watch the video where I put some snake skin under the stereo microscope, and another video that I have here is a video where I show you under the stereo microscope the differences between bugs and beetles, so another insect video. I hope that you enjoyed it, the video. Please do consider subscribing to the channel, and also please do visit my other links, and also do support the channel. I do have a Patreon page and also a webshop, an affiliate webshop from Amazon, where you can buy microscopes and microscope parts. Happy microbe hunting as always, and see you around next time. Bye bye.